Okay, well, hello there, and happy 4th of July. Happy Independence Day out there, everybody in America. I hope that you're having a wonderful day today, celebrating our freedom, our country's freedom. And we live in the greatest country in the world. And we know we've got a few problems right now, but we're going to get through this by the grace of God, okay? Because God loves America. I mean, what other country on earth do you hear people say, God bless, God bless, you know? And so we love America, and we say God bless America all the time. And, you know, those words do not fall to the ground. So if there's any other country out there that wants your country to be blessed, can you know, start saying God bless your country. Because God loves the world. God so loved the world that He gave His only begotten Son, that whosoever would believe in Him should not perish but have eternal life. And so this country preaches the gospel. We've got a lot of wonderful churches. And God bless our churches, you know. Church people might not be perfect, but can you imagine us not having churches? And for sure, we don't want Sharia law to come into our country, so we have to stand up for what's right in America. We have to vote right. We have to vote correctly. A lot of people that are maybe liberals and Democrats, they, you know, I love you. I was a Democrat and more on the liberal side, although I'm been pretty patriotic since I father was a World War II Marine, and I learned my first patriotism from him. He was the most patriotic person I knew, and he taught us patriotism. And I understand it more and more these days. And so please learn, read, study, and vote correctly next time you vote. I'm not saying you didn't vote correctly last time. I'm just saying, you know, don't be like I was. Don't be like I was. Just not knowing anything about the person and going, well, I'll just check this mark here, he looks like a good guy. Don't do it that way, okay? Because what it does, it affects our country, it affects our future, it affects the way our life is going to go in the future for our children and grandchildren. I want to thank God for our troops out there fighting right now for our freedom. I thank God for everybody that has died for our country. You know, wow, what a sacrifice they have given their lives for us. And I hope that you are out there and we're out there today enjoying life in America, barbecuing, the beach, the lake, whatever you are doing, just family, simple backyard get together, or maybe you were alone today. God bless you also, and I hope that your day was peaceful and pleasant. And sometimes, you know, when we're alone, we can celebrate with a hot dog by ourselves, you know. Stick it on the burner on the stove if you don't have a barbecue, and do the best you can. God bless everybody out there, including corporate jet owners, and including students that want scholarships. Let's don't rely on the government for, and you know, I'm not condemning anybody. I'm just saying, let's move towards more freedom from the government. God gave us this country and our government. We're not the type of people that are far right wing, you know, people that hate our government. No, we love our government because it's part of America. It's part of what God gave us. And so I'm going to be part of the group that turns the view of conservatives and Republicans. I'm going to try to be the type of person that, and you know, you might see from some of my tweets and Facebook posts, I can get pretty wild, but I love you, whoever you are, and I know I'm all over the place and with this video, but I did want to pop in here and say hi and say happy 4th of July. I've been watching this Casey Anthony trial, and I know that you've maybe seen some of my tweets and Facebook posts and stuff, so I just got involved in watching this last week. Because I used to watch so much court TV that I kind of got burned out on it, and my heart, as a prayer warrior, my thing is news and prayer. Okay, that's my website. If you want to go to my website, news and prayer, I pray about everything. Missing children has been one of my biggest top priorities as far as things go, like personal tragedies and stuff. I see the Amber Alert up there. I pray for missing children. There's missing children out there even today that we aren't aware of who they are, but they're out there, and those people, their families know who they are. And so when I pray, I put my heart into, just keep this in mind, anybody can pray, whoever you are, the simplest prayer that goes up to God, and asking Him in faith, be bold with the Lord, and ask Him in faith, whatsoever you ask in prayer, you know, God will do it for you, you know. And sometimes it takes a while. Sometimes our prayers are go unanswered. You know, there's that song, Thank God for Unanswered Prayer, but when it comes to some things, but let me see, what else do I want to talk about here? I know I got on George Anthony, the grandfather of Kaylee Anthony, and so I'm not saying that I don't think that the mother did it, but I really was pushing for looking at this from another angle, just in case, okay, because there are some questionable things about George Anthony that seemed not right. So I'm praying that the jury will come up with the right decision for this woman, the mother. I know she's flaky, but you know, and I know, you know, people say, well, she's a liar, don't defend her. I'm not defending her in any way. But you also can't base, just because somebody appears to be a bad person doesn't mean that they are and that they would do something like that. I was just looking at it from another angle, the opposite angle of everybody else looking at it. So, but, you know, if she's guilty, then so be it. She's guilty. What else? My social network marketing business, I want to invite anybody that wants to get on board with me to advertise, to sponsor me, invite you on. I'll put in a good word for you, and accordingly, go on my newsandprayer.com. Go down there to the bottom. I'm doing it. I do everything in faith, and sometimes I don't know what I'm doing. So people go, okay, well, she's not doing this right. But, hey, I'm doing it as right as I know how to do it. And I'm believing that God is going to really bless me, and I'm going to be a blessing to a lot of people. And so God provides. The Lord provides all of our needs according to His riches and glory by Christ Jesus. Do not fear. Bind the spirit of fear from you people out there. And I thank God for all my family that I've been meeting on Facebook. Sent out a special happy 4th of July, Independence Day, to my family that I've been meeting up with, cousins that I've never really known, and cousins that I've known as a child, maybe just one or two times, and then a few other cousins that I knew more as a child. One of my cousins on there, remember going out to her house, and my very first time I put lipstick on was at her house, and she reminded me that her mother used to sell Avon and those little tubes, you know, the little samples. So I'm going, yeah, that was it. And I remember that was the first time I wore lipstick, and I love my lipstick, and so I haven't quit wearing lipstick. I love it. If I do nothing else to my face, I go out the door with lipstick on. And so, God bless Sarah Palin and her lipstick, too. But anyway, you know, I hope you all have a great week ahead. Hang in there. The joy of the Lord is our strength. Stay positive. Pray for America, that God upholds us by His grace, and He will. And don't forget to pray for our troops every day, please. And I'm sure I have a lot more to say, but this is all for now, probably. Probably going to watch this Washington thing on Fox News tonight, if it's on there. The 4th of July celebration in Washington, D.C. I know around our county we've got a ton of fireworks and places, and I've seen so much fireworks in my life. I say, you've seen one fireworks, you've seen them all, but it's wonderful to go out with your family. And the other last night we had a little mini fireworks over here just outside the window. We saw it, and I mean, I thought the neighbors were just popping off some fireworks, you know, some little ones. But we looked out the window, and there was, you know, big mini fireworks show for us in the neighborhood. And so, what else? I guess that's it. I just love you guys. And, oh, I had so much fun chatting with some of my Twitter friends. I know if you see this video, sometimes I can't get to you all. I want to follow all of you more. I can't, because I'll get up there to my ratio of following people is over who follows me right now. And I know that I don't follow everybody. And some people I block if I see somebody coming on there that don't have any followers and they don't follow anybody and they're trying to push something on me. I just block them, because you see that ratio of those numbers of tweets and then 00. Something's wrong there. I really like just real. And so any of my new friends, and if we don't see eye to eye politically, there's more beyond politics. I really want your success. I want God to bless your business, and God bless the poor. The Bible says that we remember the poor. In Galatians it says, do this one thing, we remember the poor. So God bless everybody that gives to the poor and organizations and helps and prays for people to get up out of the situation of poverty. I've been there, done that. Believe me, I have been there, done that. Okay, as a single mom. And so we are compassionate, okay? Conservatives are compassionate. We want you to be pulled up and blessed, not by the government, less taxes on the businesses and your income tax. It makes sense to me since I've been learning, okay? I'm not trying to sway you either way or any way. I'm just saying what I learned, okay? I'm just trying to explain it to you. I'm trying to be a teacher a little bit, okay? My dad wanted me to be a teacher, and when I got to college, I went to college for 8 years full-time, okay, and I didn't know how to think for myself. And now I think too much for myself. But no, I'm doing great. I'm the happiest right now in my life that I've ever been, because I'm thinking right. I'm thinking more correctly in my life and politically wise. And but when I was in college, my dad wanted me to be a teacher. Well, I didn't know what I wanted to be, so I go, okay, I'll be a teacher. So I was in the education department for 5 years, but I hit a snag, and my snag was this, that I was so afraid to stand up and do the speech class, which was required to go in and take your education classes. So what I did was I just took electives from then on out. Then I changed my major from education to dance, and because I fell in love with dancing. I had some friends that did ballet and modern dance, and I got into that. This was before I was a Christian even. And then I went to the University of Oregon for 3 years, so eight years altogether. And then I met Jesus. I got so lonely. I got so depressed. I was looking for love, and I was looking out the window and go, is there any love out there? And I looked across at this church, and then I just went into this church, not the same one, but another one, one day on Sunday, and accepted him as my Lord and Savior. I just went down when he had the altar call, the pastor, and I've never regretted making that decision. And all you Christians out there know what I'm talking about. When you make that decision to become a Christian, you never regret it, no matter what you go through. We go through a lot of stuff being a Christian, but you never regret, because you know in the end where you're going. You know without absolute, you know absolutely where you're going to go, okay? It's a surety. And so just say a little prayer. I believe in Jesus. I believe you died for my sins, Lord. Come into my life. Forgive me for my sins. You can do that by yourself and God, and then just go tell somebody, get into a church, ask him for, start reading your Bible first. If you do nothing else, start reading the Word of God, the New Testament. Feed your soul, feed your spirit with the Word of God. And what else? I'm probably going to start singing on here one of these days. I hope you don't mind. I'm grabbing this t-shirt. I'm still proud to be an American. How about you? I am still proud to be an American, and I love America, and I know you do too, whoever you are. That's it, I guess. I love you, and have a good evening, blessed evening, and a blessed week, okay? Bye-bye.